Hello my dear students, I welcome you all to the exercise 2.2 of Pythagoras theorem. Second exercise is again it has a very less number of now introductory theorems. One of the very important theorem is Apollonius theorem. This is really a very important theorem and it plays a very easy and major role. Apollonius theorem. Apart from that, we have got acute angled theorem and obtuse angled theorem that you have to understand. You have to understand this application of this theorem and then it's all done. See, Apollonius theorem, what is needed, that of course it is applicable in triangle, all the three theorems, acute angled triangle theorem, obtuse angled triangle theorem and Apollonius theorem, all are applicable in a triangle. But in a triangle, when a median is there, median, what is a median? Median is a segment joining a vertex of triangle and midpoint of its opposite side. It will be connecting, supposing if this is a triangle, from this vertex it will go and connect to the midpoint of the opposite side. The vertex is this, the opposite side is this. So wherever is the midpoint, if supposing this is the midpoint, so it will be connecting this. So this is called as a median. It will be these two segments will be equal. Sorry, are you understanding my dear student? This will be called as a median. This segment is called as a median. Of course, every triangle has three medians because three vertices, three sides. So from this vertex, the opposite side is this one and then the midpoint is this one. This will be the another median. Again, here there is a vertex, the opposite side is this and then here somewhere is the midpoint and then they will draw it. And of course, you remember that all the three medians, they will be intersecting at one point. That intersecting point is called as a centroid. Okay. Again, many properties are there of a centroid and everything. At this moment, we have to understand what is a median, because Apollonius theorem is applicable only when in a triangle a median is there. And then how is it applied, and when it applies, then what is the equation that we get? So if supposing this is triangle PQR, this is the midpoint of the opposite side, this is the median, PS is the median. So what we'll do that, my dear students, that from this vertex the median is coming, right? The PS is the median. So after application of Apollonius theorem, this is the median. From here, when I talk about the triangle, triangle is PQR. Remember, when I am applying the Apollonius theorem, applying it in triangle PQR, at that time PS has got no role to play in triangle PQR, definitely. So when I start the theorem, it is starting from this vertex P. So what are the two sides of the triangle at this vertex? PQ and PR, right? The median is starting from the vertex of the triangle P. So PQ square plus PR square, PQ square plus PR square is equal to, now the median itself, 2PS square plus 2. Now the opposite side, you can take any segment, QS square or SR square, you can take anybody, okay, 2QS square or SR square, anyone, because basically both are going to be equal anyhow. So 2QS square, this is the application of the theorem. After applying Apollonius theorem, this is what you will get. Are you getting, my dear students? See, I'll apply it one more time for you all people, but this time I'll change the median. Okay, supposing this is triangle PQR, now I take this as a median on this, fine, and this is the midpoint T. So here we will have this midpoint, fine, here this was the midpoint, fine. Now what we will have, see, the median is coming from the vertex Q. So by Apollonius theorem, from this vertex Q, the two sides of triangle PQR, QP square plus QR square, okay? QP square plus QR square is equal to, now you will have to take the median itself, 2, but here 2, QT square plus 2. Now the median has got two midpoints, two mid segments, RT square, PT square. You can take any one. TR square or TP square, you can take any one. This is how you will get. Okay, I'll apply it once more for you all people. This time I'll take the third median. P, Q, R. This is the median. Now U. Fine. Now when I apply the Apollonius theorem, it is starting from the vertex R. So I will get R P square plus R Q square. R P square plus R Q square is equal to 2 median itself, 2 R U square plus 2. Now you can take either UP or UQ, 2 UQ square, that is all. This is what is called as application of Apollonius theorem. Okay, my dear students, I hope you all are getting this. Watch this video, make your own names, make your own triangles, and do keep on applying this theorem. This really is a very good theorem and it has got heavy chances of coming for 2 marks or 1 marks. And of course, it plays a major role. When it plays a role, I'll show you one question we have left out in exercise 2.1. I'll show you how easily it makes things available for you all people. So now coming over here, the acute angled triangle theorem. And obtuse angled triangle theorem. Now, of course, what is happening? Acute angled triangle, definitely the triangle will be like this. It is an acute angle triangle. All three angles are acute, less than 90 degree. So if supposing like this it is there, ABC, any triangle ABC. Now only thing is that I will require a height and altitude. One altitude I will require. That is all. In Apollonius theorem, we require a median. In acute angle triangle and obtuse angle triangle, we require altitude. That is a perpendicular from the vertex to the opposite side. Okay. So now we have to start over here. See, you can take any side. Supposing if this is an acute angle, so this is the opposite side. Okay, fine. I am taking AC square. The opposite angle is acute angle. Are you getting AC square? You can take any one side, any, I am telling my dear students. But then if I take altitude on BC, if I take altitude on BC, then I can take side AC or side AB, anyone. AC square or AB square, anyone I can take, depending on the question that I am dealing with. Okay, if supposing if I would have got altitude over here on this side A B C, then I would require to take AB square or BC square because altitude is on AC. Okay, altitude is on AC. Fine. So here the altitude is on BC, so I can take either AC square or I can take AB square depending on what the question is demanding from me. If I take AC square, AC square is equal to, now this is the opposite vertex, BA square. It is BA square plus just a minute. See, AC square is equal to BA square plus, this is opposite vertex, BA square plus, now from B you will take BC to BC into BD. Remember, once the whole side you will take, the side of the triangle BC, another time from that B to the altitude D. Sorry, this is minus over here. For acute angle triangle, it is minus over here. Okay, so it is like this. Okay, my dear students. This is getting too wet. See, I'll take it again once more. Acute angle triangle theorem. See, basically it is an acute angle triangle, so it is an acute angle. What was that? That was wrongly done, I suppose. Which one was that? A B C, and then there is a perpendicular drawn over here. Fine. Now when I am taking this perpendicular, then I can apply acute angle to get either AC square or AB square. Fine. Are you getting, my dear students? I can apply it to either get AC square or AB square. I can't go for BC square. Okay, so here what do I get? AC square is equal to, opposite vertex is this, BA square plus BC square. Now comes minus to whole segment, you can take BC into from B to the height BD. That's all. Okay, now this is very clear. See, I can take for AB square also. Same acute angle triangle theorem will give me AB square. But in that case, what will be AB square? The opposite vertex is now C. From here, CA square plus CB square. CA square plus CB square. Acute, that's why it is minus. Now from C, I will take the whole segment CB to CB into CD. Okay, my dear students, this is all. This is all that you have to take, and then you have to understand this. And if you understand acute angle triangle theorem, then obtuse angle triangle will be very easy for you all people. Except for obtuse angle, what happens that here there is a plus sign. See, you can change this also in the way that you want. Want means actually according to the demand of the question, not that you can take in any way that you feel. You will have to take it as per what your question is demanding. This is the vertex D. Now this is the altitude BD. Now I can apply it for AB square also and BC square also. So if I take acute angle triangle for BA square, AB square, the opposite vertex is C, is equal, AB square is equal to CB square plus CA square plus, no sorry, minus 2 into from C, the whole segment CA into C to the vertex, to the altitude CD. Okay, I took it for AB square. Supposing I want BC square, then BC square is equal to, the opposite vertex is A, from AB square plus AC square minus 2, from A I will take the segment AC into from A to the altitude AD. That's all. This is acute angle triangle. Same if supposing I have to go for obtuse angle triangle, then for obtuse angle triangle, my dear students, what happens is that you have only one obtuse angle. Though it is an obtuse angle triangle, only one obtuse angle will be there. So you will be able to apply only on this side, the angle, the side opposite to the obtuse angle. supposing if this is P, Q, R, the side opposite to obtuse angle, over there you will be able to apply obtuse angled triangle theorem. Okay, but of course you will require an altitude, and for all, as we know, we have done in chapter number 1, for obtuse angle the altitude will always go outside the triangle over here somewhere. This is S. Okay, now remember this is the altitude. As this is the altitude D over here, the altitude point D over here, the altitude point D over here, altitude point is S over here. Obtuse angle triangle you are going to apply, so it will be applicable only on PR square, because side opposite to obtuse angle is PR. You can't apply it on PQ, then it will be a acute angle triangle theorem. Neither can't, that's all. Okay, fine. So PR square is equal to, of course you will do the same thing, opposite vertex is Q, QP square plus QR square. Obtuse angle is always plus 2 into the whole segment QR into QS. Same thing. See, here also we did the same. BC square is equal to the opposite vertex AB square plus AC square minus 2 into AC into, from A you once go the whole segment, and second time you go to the vertex point, altitude point AD. Are you getting? Here also we did the same thing. AC square is equal to ABA square plus BC square, BA square plus BC square, and second time minus 2 into, from B once you go to the whole segment, whole side, and second time you go up to the altitude point BD. Are you getting? Similarly here I will go for the whole segment 2 into QR into Q, say altitude point QS. That's all. Okay, my dear student, this is how we are going to apply acute angle triangle theorem and obtuse angle triangle theorem. Okay, and with this I think we are ready enough to solve the exercise. Okay, in the solved examples you have got one question definitely. Actually many are there, but one very important question, very nice question. Prove that some of the squares of the diagonals of a rhombus. Prove that some of squares of diagonal of a rhombus is equal to the sum of squares of its sides. What does this mean? Sum of the square of diagonal of rhombus. Diagonals of rhombus. First of all, you require a rhombus. Basically, this is a rhombus. Rhombus means all sides are equal and diagonals perpendicularly bisect each other. Bisect each other. See, now supposing we have got this P, Q, R, S. We know that now it is given to us, quadrilateral P, Q, R, S is a rhombus. That is all. To prove, sum of squares of diagonals of rhombus means we have to do sum. Sum of what? Squares of diagonals. The diagonals are PR square plus QS square. This is squares of the diagonals. Sum of squares of the diagonals. Sum of squares of diagonals is equal to sum of squares of its sides. Means sides are taken, squares of sides are taken, and then they are all added. So we have to take the sides PS. Mm-hmm. पी क्यू क्यू आर आर एस फाइन पी एस पी क्यू क्यू आर आर एस साइड्स आर टेकन बट देन स्क्वायर्स ऑफ द साइड्स आर टेकन एंड देन दे आर ऑल एडेड सम ऑफ द स्क्वायर्स ऑफ द साइड्स दे आर पी आर स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू एस स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू पी एस स्क्वायर प्लस पी क्यू स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू आर स्क्वायर प्लस पी एस स्क्वायर सी माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑलवेज पे अटेंशन ऑन एनी वन साइड कैन यू गेट एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर पी आर स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू एस स्क्वायर और यू कैन गेट एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर दिस सी वन थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू बी वेरी क्लियर दैट इट इज अ रॉम्बस एंड बिकॉज इट इज अ रॉम्बस द डायगनल्स विल परपेंडिकुलरली बायसेक्ट इच अदर मीन्स दिस पी ओ इज इक्वल टू दिस ओ आर सॉरी पी ओ इज इक्वल टू ओ आर एट द सेम टाइम क्यू ओ इज इक्वल टू ओ एस रिमेंबर ओ इज अ मिड पॉइंट ऑफ पी आर एंड ओ इज ऑल्सो द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ क्यू एस दैट इज वॉट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड दैट इज वॉट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर ओके माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स सो नाउ नेक्स्ट इज वॉट दैट वी हैव टू सी इज जस्ट अ मिनट सी कैन यू वॉट कैन यू गेट टू गेट पी आर स्क्वायर एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर पी आर स्क्वायर देन इन ट्राइंगल पी एस आर आई विल हैव टू यूज अक्यूट एंगल ट्राइंगल थ्योरम वगैरह बट सी इट्स वेरी इजी ओवर हियर पी एस स्क्वायर प्लस पी क्यू स्क्वायर सी पी एस स्क्वायर प्लस पी क्यू स्क्वायर इफ आई गो इन ट्राइंगल पी क्यू एस इफ आई गो इन ट्राइंगल पी क्यू एस फाइन इफ आई गो इन ट्राइंगल पी क्यू एस देन पी ओ इज द मीडियन कैन यू सी दिस पी ओ इज अ मीडियन फाइन पी ओ इज अ मीडियन पी ओ इज अ मीडियन I can apply Pythagoras theorem, I will get PS square plus PQ square. Fine. Similarly, when I go for this triangle, QRS, again, RO is a median. Here also, I will get RQ square plus RS square. Are you getting? So, that's what I have to do. See, in triangle PQS, PQS, No, but you have to prove that. Quadrilateral PQRS is a rhombus. This is since diagonals of rhombus bisect each other. Therefore, O is a midpoint of PR. You don't require that also will require. O is midpoint of PR 1. O is midpoint of QS. So this means O is midpoint of QS. Therefore, PO will become the median. That we have proved now. This we have to make it clear. Now you will tell in triangle PQS, PO is a median. This is from O is a midpoint on QS, na? PO is a median from 2. So, by Apollonius theorem, this is a median. From vertex P, are you getting this is O, midpoint. P is a vertex. So from vertex P, PQ square plus PS square. PQ square plus is equal to 2 into, once you will take the median itself, PO square plus, now you can take anything, 2 PO square plus 2 QO square or 2 OS square, anything. 2 QO square. Fine, this is by Apollonius theorem. This will be your point 3. Now, similarly, we will go in triangle QRS because we want what? See, we have got PQ square plus PS square. Now we want QR square plus RS square. That will come from this triangle. So in triangle QRS, again OR is a, RO is a midpoint, is a median. RO is a median because O is the midpoint of QS. It is from point 2. So again you will tell, if RO is a median, the vertex is R, RQ square plus RS square is equal to 2 RO square, median itself. Now you can take 2 OQ square or OS square, but I will take OQ square because once I have taken, by okay, my dear students, now if I add 3 and 4, so I will get PQ square plus PS square plus RQ square plus RS square. That is, that will complete this. Are you getting? So adding 3 and 4, we get what? Left hand side plus left hand side. PQ square plus PS square plus RQ square plus RS square. This all you have to copy as it is equal to 2PO square plus 2QO square plus 2RO square plus 2QO square. So do you have any like terms over here? Now left hand side is ready. See, this is the left hand side, it is ready, PS square plus PQ, so this is ready. So now this we are not going to disturb, but definitely here we have to do lots, nothing is needed. I suppose PR square and QS square, and this is nothing is needed, PO is not needed, QO is not needed. The first we will take a look at the like terms. If you will see over here, 2QO square, 2QO square like terms, PO square and RO square you don't have. Okay, so now we have to go PO square and RO square. Okay, first I will write the what here, they are 2 PO square plus 2 RO square plus 4 QO square. You don't want anybody out of this, neither you want PO, neither you want RO, neither you want QO. Instead of them you want what? PR and QS. You have to convert them to the whole thing. See, this if you will remove PO, if you want to convert to the diagonal, PO is equal to what of PR? Remember, PO is equal to what? Because O is the midpoint of PR. So PO is what? PO is half of PR. If supposing PR is 20, so PO will be 10 and 10. If PR is 100, so PO will be 50. That means PO is half of PR. So this is your point number 5. We don't want PO, that's why PO is equal to half of PR. Why? Because O is a midpoint of PR from 1. We have proved it over here from 1. So PO, but I want PO square, PR square upon 4. Fine. This is my point number 6. Okay, also I don't want RO. RO is what? Again, RO is also half of PR, hai na? RO is equal to half of PR. This is also from 1, so I will get RO square is equal to again PR square upon 4. This will be 6. Okay, so RO also got, and QO square also I don't want. QO will be half of QS, right? QO will be half of QS. QO half of QS. But this is why, because point of O is the midpoint of QS. It is in from point 2. From point 2. So QO square will be equal to QS square upon 4. Are you getting? I am doing the square of everything. QO square, 1 square is 1, QS square and 2 square is 4. So everything I am doing the same over here. PO is equal to half of PR. When I find the square of both the sides, so PO square is equal to PR square upon 4. 1 into PR will be PR. So 1 square also will be 1. 1 into PR, PR square. And then 2 square will be 4. So likewise, I am getting everywhere QS square upon 4. Okay, this is done. So now I have got the value of PO square, I have got the value of RO square, I have got the value of QO square. So 6, 7, 8, I will substitute in equation 5. So rest will be same, PQ square plus PS square plus RQ square plus RS square is equal to, in place 2 will be also there, 2 also I have to write 2 into PO square will be PR square upon 4 plus 2 also I will have to write, this I will do, RO square will be PR square upon 4 plus 4 into QO square will be QS square upon 4. So here 2, 2s are 4, 2s are 4 and this 4 will get cancelled. So what I get over here is that PQ square PR square upon 2 plus PR square upon 2 plus QS square. Now PR square upon 2, PR square upon 2, this will give me 2 PR square upon 2 plus QS square is equal to still this whole thing. Now here 2, 2 will get cancelled and what stays is only this PQ square plus PS square plus RQ square is equal to PR square plus QS square. This is what we have to prove. Better write in one more statement. Okay, so like this it is, my dear student. This is one of the very important questions, very nice questions. You have to understand this question and then you are ready to solve the exercise. In exercise I think you will have only one question which is that much tough, otherwise most of the questions are very easy. And of course one more question of previous exercise we have to solve. So here we start with exercise 2.2. okay, so to start with the exercise, the first question asks us to deal with what? In triangle PQR, S is the midpoint of side QR. This is supposing triangle. S is the midpoint of side QR. PQR. S is the midpoint of this. Okay. So midpoint is come, so Poulenc's theorem will come. PQ is equal to 11 they have given, PR is equal to 17 they have given, PS is equal to 13. Find QR. But while asking, they have asked you this. So given you will have PS is a median. Fine. And then PQ is equal to 11, PR is equal to 17. PS is equal to 13. Find. Remember they have asked you to find QR. Fine. But now when you will S is the midpoint, remember this. So while applying Apollonius theorem, you will get QS or SR. You will not get QR directly. So solution, if when you start in triangle PQR, PS is a median. This is given always, because median is there, only then you will be able to apply Apollonius theorem. So bring it to notice that you have got a median. So by applying, this is the median. So by applying Apollonius theorem, PR square plus PQ square will be equal to 2 into the median itself, PS square, plus 2 into any one section, QS square or SR square, 2QS square by Apollonius theorem. Fine. Now you will start your substitution. PR square is 17 square plus 11 square is equal to 2 into PS square is 13 square plus 2QS square. This is substitution that you have done. 17 square is 289, I suppose. Yes, it is 289. Plus 11 square is 121. 13 square is 169. You are solving all this. So if I add this, 289 plus 189, 9 plus 110, 9, 10, 11. 410 is equal to 2 9s are 18, 2 6s are 12, 13, 2 1s are 2, 3 plus 2QS square. I have solved this multiplication 338 and I have added this 410. Now 338 goes on the other side. Because it is going on the other side, the sign will change. Minus 338 is equal to 2QS square. If I subtract this 8, 9, 10, 72, okay, will be the remainder. Now 2 will go on the other side. 2 is a coefficient. So when you shift the coefficient will go and divide on the other side. You will get 236. QS square is equal to 36. So when you will take square root of both the sides, QS is equal to 6. So that's what you have got now, QS. But remember, you are not asked to find QS. You have to find QR. And whatever is QS, double of that will be QR. QR is always double of QS. Remember that. If QS is 10, QR will be 20. If QS is 100, QR will be 200. So QR will be double of QS. Reason is midpoint property. So QR will be equal to 2 into 6 So this is how you will be solving your first question. So we go to the next question, which demands what? In triangle ABC, AB is equal to 10, AC is equal to 7, BC is equal to 9, then find the length of the median drawn from the point C to side ABC. So from point C, this is triangle ABC, median is drawn from point C, this will be point C to side AB. This is the median drawn over here. Supposing this median is D, this is the median now, CD is the median. Okay, in triangle ABC, AB is equal to 10. Now here complete AB is given to you, 10. This has got no role to play in the Apollonius theorem. AC is equal to 7. BC is equal to 9 and they are asking you to find CD. Okay, again in given you will have in triangle ABC, CD is median, AC is equal to 7, BC is equal to 9, AB is equal to 10. This you have to be very careful because AB you are not going to use anyway. You are going to use either AD or DB. Find CD. You have to find the median, find the length of the median. So solution starts. Remember, while applying Apollonius theorem, you will be requiring either AD or DB. So you have to find AD first. So here, AD is equal to what? Half of AB. So this you have to understand. Half of AB. Why? Midpoint property or property of a median. So AD will be equal to half of 10. So AD will be equal to 5. Fine. Now you are free to apply Apollonius theorem. in triangle ABC, CD is median. This is given. Therefore, CD is a median. The from vertex is CA square plus CB square. CA square plus CB square is equal to median itself 2 into CD square plus 2 into either AD square or AB square, but I'll take AD. 2AD square by Apollonius theorem. Now I have to do substitution. AC square is equal to 7 square. BC square is equal to 9 square. CD square, I don't know CD. 2 into AD is 5, I found from here. 5 square. So 7 square will be 49, 9 square will be 81. 2 into CD square plus 2 into 25. Okay, this I have found, this I have solved, and this I have solved. Fine. Now I will add this 9, 10, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 130. This I have solved. Is equal to 2 into CD square plus 50. This I have solved. Now 50 comes over here, I get 130 minus 50 is equal to 2 into. If I subtract this, 80 I'll get. Okay. 80 is equal to 2. So 80 divided by 2 will be. So you will get CD square is equal to 40. Fine. And then I have to find the square root of CD. To find the square root of CD, what I will have to do is, that is 40. 220s are, 210s are, 25s are, 51s are. This will go out of the radical, but this 2 volt. So this will be, it's equal to 2 root 10 units. Let me check the answer at the back, because slightly different answer, it is always nice to check which one are we doing. Second one, that's all right. Fine. 2 root 10 units. Okay, my dear students, so we have reached now here question number third will be acute angle triangle theorem. I'll first go to question number fourth, my dear students, because I'll cover one type of questions. I'll come back to question number 3. See here, in triangle ABC, they have given the figure over here. ABC. This is again very important, my dear students. Most of the time when it comes to Apollonius theorem, these type of questions are asked. Here they have given, in triangle ABC, M is midpoint of BC. So in short, AM is a median. Now they have given AB square plus AC square is equal to 290 centimeter square. See, AB they have not given separate. AB square plus AC square, whole value they have given. AM also they have given. That means median is equal to 8 centimeter. Find BC. See, find whole BC, I remember, but you will be getting either BM or MC. BM. So everything is ready over here. Solution in triangle ABC, AM is median. This is given. So AM is median, so AB square plus AC square 2 into median itself. AM square plus 2 into either BM or CM. I'll take BM. Anyone you can take. This is by Apollonius theorem. Okay. So what I get now, AB. Now here's AB square plus AC square. Whole value is given to me. 290. So in place of this whole value, I'll write 290 is equal to 2. AM is given to me 8. So this will become 290 8 जा 64, टू फोर जा 8, टू सिक्स जा 12, दिस विल गो एंड सब्ट्रैक्ट ऑन द अदर साइड. इफ यू सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस यू विल गेट 2, 5. No. 10 - 8 = 2, 6. 162 is equal to 2 BM². Now 2 comes on the other side and divides. Eight are 16, ones are. So you get BM² is equal to 81. That means BM is equal to 9 cm. But remember, they have not asked you BM, they have asked you BC. And BC will be always, BC will be double of BM. Whatever is BM, double of that will be BC. The BC is double of BM because midpoint property. So BC will be equal to double of 9. Okay, my dear students, so hope you all are getting this fine. Question number 4 also is over. So we can go to question number 5. I'll come to question number 3 in the end because it is easy basically, but it is an acute angle triangle theorem, slightly a different theorem going in different angle. We have done acute angle triangle theorem. I've done it while explaining you. With slight amount of confusion. Question number 5 definitely is a slightly complex one. Oh, now we can, instead of going for question number 5, we can go to question number 3. Because question number 3 again deals with acute angle triangle, and question number 5 also deals with acute angle triangle theorem. So in figure here, if you'll see, now this is slightly complex. See, PS is a median of triangle PQR. See, this is the QR. This is supposing your P. This is a median you require, and this is a perpendicular that you require. Fine. So like this you have got P Q R. S is a median and PT is altitude. Remember this. This is a basic difference. S is a median, S is a midpoint, point of median, and T is the point of altitude. Okay. Now here they have given everything, given not everything, but still given PS is median and PT is perpendicular to QR. To prove, what we have to prove? PR square is equal to PS square plus QR into ST plus QR upon 2 the whole square. See, my dear students, everywhere you have got plus, plus, plus. In the second one, if you will see, PS square is equal to PQ square is equal to, sorry, PQ square is equal to PS square minus QR into ST plus QR upon 2 the whole square. So, because there is a minus over here, so there are very heavy chances that you are going to use acute angle triangle theorem. Because acute angle triangle theorem gives you a negative sign. But all are positive, so definitely over here an obtuse angle triangle theorem is supposed to be applied. Sorry. If I think about applying obtuse angle triangle theorem, see, I come over here, I'll draw diagram over here again. See, if I think about applying acute obtuse angle triangle theorem. So obtuse angle is basically only triangle PSR. Can you see this? Triangle PSR. This is the only triangle that is applying obtuse angle triangle with having this PT as its altitude. Fine. Rest this is PQ is there. This is its altitude. Fine. So in triangle PS solution, in triangle PSR, by obtuse angled triangle theorem. See, obtuse angle means opposite to obtuse is PR square. PR, so you will get PR square. See, PR square, vertex is this. SP square plus SR square. Fine. SP square plus SR square plus 2 into side itself SR into ST to the point of altitude. ST. This is what you will have. If I go to compare with this, SP square I require. Otherwise, I don't require these all things. So what will happen? SR square I have to remove. Fine. See, what all things I don't require. SR I don't require. SR I don't require. You should notice this, what you don't require. ST you require. Okay. Don't bother about 2. It will take its own position. No numbers you don't have to bother. SP square you require. PS square and SP square are both same. This you require. SR square you don't require. SR you again don't require. ST you require. Can you see I am comparing this one? I'm comparing this one. PR square is equal to PS square is required. SR square is not required. It is nowhere there. 2 into SR is not required. ST is required. So I have to find the equation for SR. SR, as you know, that PS is the median. So SR will be half of QR. Right? SR will be half of QR. So SR is equal to, this is my equation 1. SR is equal to half of QR, means QR upon 2. Property of median. So in place of SR, I can write QR upon 2. But one place I require SR square. QR square upon 4. Substituting 2 and 3 in equation 1. So here if I go to substitute, I'll have to copy everything. PR square is equal to SP square plus, in place of SR square I'll write QR square upon 4 plus 2 into SR, again I don't require. In place of SR I'll write QR upon 2 into ST. Fine, everything has come. Now 2 will go, 2 will go. So here if you will see, PR square is equal to PS square plus QR into ST. QR upon 2 the whole square, basically here they, what they have done, QR upon QR square upon 4, the QR upon 2 the whole square. This is all. This is done. So this you have proved. Fine. Similarly, you have to go to do the question number 2. See, QR, don't get confused with this QR upon 4. QR square upon 4, if I take the square outside, so it will become QR upon 2 the whole square. Basically, it is this only. SR is equal to QR upon 2. If I find the square, they did not open the bracket. SR is equal to QR upon 2. If I go to find the square of both the sides, so it will be SR square is equal to QR upon 2 the whole square. they did not open the bracket. We usually open the bracket qr square upon 4, but they did not open the bracket. You have to write qr upon 2 the whole square. So now if I go to the second question, here they are asking us to use pq. So here if I see the part of the triangle, see here, now if I use the part of the triangle, I have to use now PS square. Oh my god, PS square ka obtuse angle triangle, no PQ square, that's what I was wondering. PQ square, this is PQ square ka obtuse angle will be this PSQ, PS square, yes. So that's what I was wondering. See, you can take any PS also, but then you want PQ square, side PQ square, the acute angle is opposite one. So you will have to take this triangle. Now this is P Q S R T. You require to find PQ square, and that too with obtuse angle, acute angle triangle theorem. Minus is there. So PQ ka acute will be, see, acute can be this also, PR square plus RQ square. But are you dealing with PR? You are dealing with PS. So better go for this as a acute angle triangle. For that, the altitude is this PT. Fine. So in this, if you will apply the acute angle triangle theorem in triangle PQS, by acute angle triangle theorem, you want PQ square, opposite vertex is S, SP square plus SQ square. It is acute angle triangle minus 2 into, once you will take the full segment, SQ into from here to the point of altitude ST, that is all. So this is what you have got. Now you require this, but you don't require SQ square, you don't require SQ again, ST you require. So SQ is, this is going to be your point number 4. SQ is half of RQ, QR. Now I won't do the same mistake again. QR upon 2 I require. So SQ square is equal to QR upon 2 the whole square. This is point number 5, this is point number 6. So substituting 5 and 6, in 4 we get, what do we get? See, this all I'll write, PQ square is equal to SP square plus, PQ square is equal to plus, in place of SQ the whole square I'll write QR upon 2 the whole square, minus 2 into place of SQ I'll write QR upon 2 into ST. Fine, this 2 and this 2 is gone, so I'll write PQ square is equal to SP square minus QR into ST plus QR upon 2 the square. Okay, just I brought this forward and this I took it back. So this is also we have proved. So with this we have finished question number 3. Now we have to go to question number 5. Again it will be dealing with acute angle triangle. That's why I again shifted to question number 3. Question number 5. This is slightly complex, my dear student. Not very, but still. Point T is in the interior of rectangle PQRS. See, this is a rectangle PQRS. They are telling point T is anywhere in the, anywhere, not necessary in any one direction. Now here, this is given P Q R S. So this is the point T. What they want you to do is that to prove that P to prove TS square plus TQ square is equal to TP square plus TR square. TP square plus TR square. Okay, they have given you the hint also. I showed in the figure, draw construction. Draw AB parallel to SR such that A dash T dash B, means we have to draw a line through T such that it is parallel to SR. Fine, this is what we have to do. Now see, dear students, what we have to do, actually speaking, what we have to concentrate on here, you have to remember certain things. See, basically this is a rectangle, so you have to prove that this will be 90 degree, this will be 90 degree, and this will be 90 degree, this will be 90 degree. So you have to prove this quadrilateral PQBA is also a rectangle. Why? Because then PA will be equal to QB. That's what it is. Basically PS also will be equal to QR. Because it is a rectangle, PS will be equal to QR. And also because it is a rectangle, which we have to prove. See here. Quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle and this is given. Therefore, you will have these opposite sides, PS is equal to QR. Fine, this will be your point number 1. Reason is opposite sides of rectangle. Fine, this is done, and now you have to go to prove this also is a rectangle. For that, what you will do, see, AB is parallel to SR is given, and this angle ASC here, angle ASR is equal to angle ASR, PSR. PSR is equal to angle QRS is equal to 90 degree. Again, reason is angles of angles. See, these are PSR is equal to angle QRS is equal to 90 degree. Both are 90 degree. See now, AB is parallel to SR. Construction, and then see, AB is parallel to SR and PS. See, like this it is AB parallel to SR, and this is a transversal. PS is a transversal. AB is parallel to SR. Are you getting this? AB is parallel to SR. PS is a transversal. So what you will get is these are corresponding angles. Angle PAB, angle ASR will be corresponding angles. Fine. So PS as transversal, you will get angle PAB is equal to angle PSR is equal to 90 degree. Reason is corresponding angles. Similarly, here angle QBA will be congruent to angle QRS. Angle QBA is equal to angle QRS is equal to 90 degree. Fine. So now you have got that this angle PAB is 90 degree, QBA is 90 degree, this also is 90 degree already. Therefore, quadrilateral PQBA is a rectangle. Therefore, PA will be equal to QB because fine. So we have reached up to here. This you have to keep ready. These two things, PS is equal to QR and PA is equal to QB. This is what you have to judge before starting. Now what you will do is, see my dear students, you will have to find PT square from here and TQ square from here. See, PT square from here, TQ square from here. Here means where? Basically triangle, see, I'll draw it for you. This is your P, Q, R, S, T. Fine. And this was your, this is 90 degree. So, PT square you will require. So you will find PT square. PT in acute angle triangle, opposite is acute is this. TS, P. And this will be your altitude, A. This way you will use acute angle triangle theorem in to find PT square in triangle PTS by acute angled triangle theorem. PT square will be equal to the opposite vertex is S. ST square plus SP square minus, because it is acute angle triangle, minus 2 into full segment SP into again from S to the point of altitude SA. This is your one. Similarly, in triangle, I told you to find TQ square, right? In triangle TQ, you require to find TQ square. The acute angle triangle will be TRQ. In triangle TRQ, what you will get is TQ square you have to find. Opposite acute angle is RT square plus RQ square. This is the altitude, point of altitude. RT square plus minus 2 into RB, full side RQ into RB. This is point 2. See, my dear students. Now you have to subtract these two, PT square minus TQ square. Subtracting 1 and 2. So left hand side minus left hand side will give me PT square minus t q square is equal to, now this whole left hand side, s t square plus s p square minus 2 s p into s a minus r t square plus r q square minus 2 fine. Again you will take it down, now when I open the bracket, r t square minus r q square, these all signs will go on changing now, minus plus minus, this will become plus 2 into r q into r b. Okay, now you have to take care. See, we have proved that p s is equal to, everything you have to shift on this segment, p s is equal to r q, p a is equal to q b. So see, t s you will not do anything, PS will be equal to RQ. PS will be equal to RQ. So this will be RQ square. Again, PS will be equal to RQ. AS, AS, no, do nothing you have to do over. No, AS will be equal to RB. AS will be equal to RB again. Everything you have to take on segment QR. RT square, you will not do anything, RT square. RQ square, you will not do anything. Everything you are going to bring over here, plus 2 into RQ also, you will not do anything. Into RB also, you will not do anything. Fine. So here, if you will see now, plus RQ square minus RQ square, this will get cancelled. Minus 2RQ into RB plus 2RQ into RB, this whole thing will get cancelled. So what you stay back with is PT square minus TQ square is equal to ST square minus RT square. Now only to make everything positive, you will bring PT square plus RT square is equal to ST square, this goes over there, plus TQ square, and this is what you are supposed to prove. TP square plus TR square, TP square plus TR square is equal to TS square plus TQ square, TS square plus TQ square. See, it is slightly complex, but you will have to solve this a number of times, 3-4 times you will have to solve to get it. Basically what you have to do is that you have to see, basically you are going against the stream over here. They are asking you to find TS square, TP square plus TR square, TP square plus TR square. So what you are doing, basically you are finding TP square and you are finding TQ square by using this same acute angle triangle theorem. But to, and you can directly apply, but afterwards you will have any problem that you have to shift that PS is equal to RQ, you will be able to show because it is a rectangle, but PA is also equal to RB is equal to, you have to, QB is equal to, you have to show. Also ABRS is a rectangle, you have to show, where AS is equal to BR. You will have to shift everybody over there. For that you will have to prove this quadrilateral ABRS, quadrilateral PQAB is a rectangle. Okay, so what you do over here is apply acute angle triangle over here, PTS, and apply TQ square over here, TRQ. Okay, my dear students, subtract the two and then you will have to solve, then you will have to convert everything over there. solve it 2-3 times. If you don't understand once more, I can, or afterwards we can. But you'll have to listen to this again and again. Nothing more than that, my dear students. Okay. And one more question that we are left out with, that is the previous exercise. It is very interesting question now. When you have learned Apollonius theorem, see question number 9 of exercise 2.1. See here they have told that in this triangle PRQ, PRQ, M is the midpoint. That means M is a median. Therefore, PM is a median. Fine. Here they have given M is midpoint of RQ. This is all we have given to prove. PQ square is equal to 4PM square minus 3PR square. This we have to prove. Now see, my dear students, basically it is a right angle triangle, I understand that, but still M is a midpoint, PM is a median. So we can apply Apollonius theorem. So here in of course we have to find PQ square. Try to understand. Definitely we can find an expression PQ square is equal to, by Pythagoras theorem, PR square plus RQ square, but that will definitely be a longer method. Whenever Apollonius theorem, whenever Pythagoras theorem and Apollonius theorem are coming together, it is always nice to prefer Apollonius theorem. I'll show you now. See here, in triangle PRQ, M is midpoint of RQ. This is given. Therefore, it is a median. So, PM is a median. So, from P, we will have to start PR square plus PQ square is equal to 2 into median itself PM square. Plus 2 into RM square you can take, MQ square you can take, I am taking RM square. Fine. I want to find PQ square. PQ square I want, the PR square I will shift on the other side. Okay, PR square of shift on the other side. Now what all things I want? PM square I require, PR square I require, I don't want only RM square. Can I make it out? See this 4, 3, ignore this. It will take its own course and come in the right place. Just a minute, what have I done? With this 2 extra I have written, or what? 2 PM square plus 2 RM square, this sir, that's it. PM square you require, PR square you require, you only don't require is RM square. Now RM square I can convert it into by Apollonius theorem also, and I can convert it to RQ also. RM is half of RQ, but do I require RQ? I don't require RQ. I can convert it to PM square minus PR square by applying Pythagoras theorem in this triangle. In place of RM square, I will get PM square minus PR square. PM and PR I require. So in triangle, this is my 1. I can't solve it any year further because there are unlike terms. 2 PM square, 2 RM square minus PR square. So in triangle PRM by Pythagoras theorem, you will get is hypotenuse square PM square is equal to पी आर स्क्वायर प्लस आर एम स्क्वायर. आई वॉन्ट आर एम स्क्वायर, तो आर एम स्क्वायर आई एम शिफ्टिंग पी आर स्क्वायर ऑन द अदर साइड. रिमेंबर पी आर स्क्वायर पी एम स्क्वायर माइनस पी आर स्क्वायर. सो सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग टू इन वन. What do we get? Substituting 2 in 1. Since 2 in 1 means in place of RM square I will write this whole thing. Fine. Rest of the thing I will copy. PQ square is equal to 2PM square plus 2 into the I will copy. PQ square is equal to 2PM square plus 2 into wait. In place of RM square, I will have to write this in bracket. PM square minus PR square. Then again minus PR square, I will copy. So now if you will see PM, PR, PM, PM, PR, PR, nothing is unwanted. Now I will have to only solve this so that this form comes over here. So what do I do this? PQ square is equal to 2PM square. I will solve this part. For this I will have to open the bracket, and for this I will have to multiply this on both the sides. Plus 2 PM square minus 2 PR square minus PR square. So what do I get over here? PQ square is equal to, these are like terms, PM square, 2 PM square, 2 PM square, 2 plus 2, 4 PM square minus 2 PR square minus PR square, means this is 1, minus 2 minus 1 will be minus 3 PR square. That is all. This is what they have asked you to prove. Okay, my dear students, what am I doing is over here is that I am just applying Apollonius theorem over here. When you apply Apollonius theorem, you are going to get this equation straight. PR square is plus PQ square is equal to this. Except to get PQ square, you have to shift PR square on the other side. That is the only thing you have to do, and your equation for this PQ square is ready with only one thing unwanted, that is RM. Only one thing unwanted, that is RM. Otherwise PM square you require, PR you require, only RM one you don't require. Now RM can be converted to RQ. RM is equal to half of RQ. But do you require RQ in the equation? You don't require RQ in the equation. RM can be also apply Pythagoras theorem in triangle PRM. RM will be equal to hypotenuse square PM square minus PR square. PM square minus PR square. You require PM and PR. So better go in triangle PRM and find an expression for RM square is equal to PM square minus PR square. Substitute this equation over there and your answer is there in front of you. Substitute this equation over there. Fine, and then only you have to solve. Okay, my dear student, so this was that easy. See, only this much is the problem. If the same problem you would have gone to solve without Apollonius theorem, it will definitely be a longer one to do, a very longer method to do. And in the end of the day, you are going to solve it in the boards. So it's not that you have to do it only till exercise 2.1 and solve. You can use any theorem throughout the chapter, throughout the textbook, and solve it. Okay, my dear students, so with this we finish our exercise 2.2 also, and then we can go for, in the next lecture we can go for what? This is again very important, my dear students, what we have solved, solved example. Then we can go for problem set 2 afterwards, the next lecture. You can give it a try for all these objectives, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Give it a try. Then we can go for the next of the questions. There are in total how many questions? They look like 18, but they are plenty more. 18 plus... Okay, fine. Whatever they are, we have to solve it. Okay, my dear students, so soon we'll come together for solving problem set 2, so that we finish with first two chapters of triangles, first two chapter of maths 2. Thank you, my dear students. See you all soon. Stay safe, stay home. Most importantly, stay happy. Love you all. See you all too, as soon as possible.